Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from OneHive Gazette, here with the next video, and this is another attack meta video. In these videos, as always, I'm going to be going through Town Hall 9, 10, and 11 and talking about the most popular and most successful strategies in war right now. I also want to do a defensive meta video to talk to you guys about what's working defensively. Those are a little bit harder to make, but I'm going to do my best to help you guys in that regard as well. But for today, we're just focusing on the most popular and successful attack strategies, and this should help you know what to practice and what to focus on for your upgrades. So that all being said, let's take a look at some Town Hall 11 meta strategies right now, and it's pretty much going to be all La Lune if we're talking 3-stars. We have 2 3-stars to take a look at today, both from Immoral Thieves, my last war covering Immoral Thieves before I have to focus my time on the clans in the Premier League. So my farewell coverage was a great war against the Swarm. Had some awesome Town Hall 11 triples. These are two great ones. And you'll notice that you start off just by biting off a small piece of the base. It's going to be with your heroes. Typically, you're going to save that warden for your balloons. And you're just going to make that clockwise or counterclockwise, in this case, motion around the base. You have some tools to use. The warden's ability, typically you want to use that for like the first Inferno Tower. That's when the damage is the highest, when you have, you know, the most at stake. Use the warden's ability to get through either like the Eagle, if it's still up, or the first Inferno. You also have a heal to heal those balloons up between Infernos. That's typically a good choice to bring. And you have a freeze to freeze one of the Infernos. Look at this, 3 Lava Hounds left up. It's too easy. I'd say he has a solid 18 balloons in there maybe. 3 Lava Hounds, his Grand Warden, cleanup troops, crush this base. Cleanup is so slow because he had 3 Lava Hounds that didn't pop. Only one of his 4 actually exploded, I believe. Great stuff. We'll take a look at one more that I will talk through a little better without the introduction. But yeah, nice attack to Wicked 1 there, getting the triple on that Town Hall 11 base. So taking a look at the next one here, this is Ma Vuong, I want to say. Also, in Immoral Thieves, of course. And this is another great example. You're only going to be able to do this at this point in the game on the Town Hall 11 bases that are anti 2-star. It's very difficult to 3-star a good anti 3-star Town Hall 11 layout, and there's enough bases that still are anti 2-star to try to defend Town Hall 10 2-star attempts that there'll be plenty to choose from that are not going to be laid out in a difficult way. So this base, you can see, gives access to the Inferno, the air defense, and the Eagle. Now, you don't always have to take out the Queen. There's different points of value that you want to look to get. You want to get typically an air defense. You want to try to get an Inferno or the Eagle. Those are all good, valuable defenses. The Queen is nice to get too, but if the Queen is not in a good position, you do not have to get her. You can see the attacker has a skeleton spell, and that's going to be for taking out the Queen. Also, the Lava Hounds naturally are going to pop on the air defenses, and there's an air defense near the Queen there, so the pups will help with her as well. I think the Warden might even help the Queen, help take out the Queen a little bit too, although he's not that reliable. So there's many tools to use beyond the Kill Squad to take out the Queen. The important thing is your Kill Squad gets good value for a small investment. Now, the Warden does get kind of far out in front right here, so he has to pop the ability in a little bit of an awkward location because the Teslas were about to attack the Warden. But things work out fine. Has the heal spell for the balloons. Actually has 2 heal spells. They have really become popular at Town Hall, pretty much all Town Hall levels, but these Town Hall 11 triples especially, to keep these balloons up over the Wizard Towers. You can see it helps to have the Lava Hound in the defensive CC, and that is popular, so most of the time you will have the advantage of having that Lava Hound in the CC, because your heroes, if you send in your kill squad away from the CC, they can take out their chunk of the base without having to deal with that Hound, and then it will just sit there for the entire attack, although sometimes you might want to bring an archer to draw it to the corner if it's going to be lured, so it's not sitting there for your cleanup troops to have to worry about. That'll do it for this Town Hall 11 look, and now we'll take a look at some Town Hall 10s. So we're going to first start with a Town Hall 10 v Town Hall 11 2-star attempt, just going to show one of these because it's not, you know, hugely important, but it's worth showing because, you know, obviously not all Town Hall 11s are three-starred in the war. In fact, it's still not very common that we see Town Hall 11 three-stars. So this is an important skill, and the quicker the Town Hall 10s two-star these Town Hall 11s, the quicker and the more attacks they'll be available for getting the three-star attempts on the Town Hall 10s to free up Town Hall 11 attacks to go where it's needed. So this attack is by Big Sub-Zero in our last CWL war. You can see he's starting off with a queen walk. Probably the most common is going to be the queen walk hobo attack, or not hobo, bolo with, or gobo, queen walk gobo. I know it's something like that. Yeah, golem and bowlers. That's the important part. Basically, the queen, just put her down somewhere to get percentage and also to create a funnel for your troops to get those bowlers to the middle of the base here. Now, he's going to drop down a golem and some more bowlers to create the funnel. Keep in mind, this attack can be done with Valks as well. You can send the Valks up the gut after the funnel has been created. They're a bit of a different troop. If the base is very compact like this, you might want to go with the bowlers because the second bounce is so powerful. The Valks can get caught up if they the buildings touching tend to draw them even deeper into the base, into weird locations. So it's a little bit riskier with the Valks. The bowlers are a little bit more reliable right now for Town Hall 11 two-star attempts. But Baby Dragon, Valk is also a combo that can work. This is just the most popular one, so I wanted to show it. You can see the queen actually stayed up for a very long time. She does go down right here, but got great value there. And about 60 or 59%. That's pretty good for a Town Hall 10 two-star on an 11. An important skill, so practice your bowler, queen walk, whatever you want to call it, and also practice Valks in certain situations. We do see dragons a little bit, but not as much as we used to. Bowlers are the main way to go. So let's move on to some Town Hall 10s, and you'll notice right off the bat with Town Hall 10s, we're going to be looking mostly at air attacks. Now we have three Town Hall 10 attacks we're going to be focusing on today. The first two are how to deal with these bases that have the offset air defenses. Now I know some of you guys out there see regular Town Hall 10 bases. In that case, go back, take a look at my last, or not my last video, a while back I've talked about how to use like a Valk Laloon combination to take out the standard Town Hall 10 bases. Those are easier to 3-star with this Laloon. The tricky thing is getting the 3-star on these Town Hall 10 bases that have offset air defenses to specifically defend Laloon. But you just gotta make adjustments and be creative. You can see Black Panther drops in his heroes, gets the Inferno and two air defenses. The Queen is still up, but the Queen has become less of an issue lately with the Skeleton Spell. The Lava Pups, as always, can do damage to her, and you can poison her as well to slow her down. So all those things are good tools to help take out the Queen. You can see his Queen actually is going to come around, get the Tesla taken out, and start to step up for that last air defense, but it doesn't matter, the balloons are there anyway. And they will close in on those last air defenses. Awesome attack to Black Panther. Like I said, being creative at Town Hall 10, you don't have to always be afraid of the defenses when there's no air defenses to for your Lava Hound to latch onto. You can just go straight up, send a few Lava Hounds on a flyby to tank momentarily and soak up air traps and have those balloons just follow behind under a lot of spells. That can work. The balloons have hit points. They can stay up in certain situations. If you have the right spells on them, they are pretty tanky in some situations, as long as there's not too much damage on them. Now, this next attack I wanted to show because it is kind of the other side of the equation, I guess you could say. Basically, when you see the offset air defenses like this, you also have the option of going for the Wizard Towers, the Archer Towers, the Expos on the other side of the base and leaving the air defense cannon area for your Laloon attack. So you're going to see here Tong Giang comes in here with the King to grab that Inferno, grab the Queen, also has a few Valks to back up his King. Good investment there, almost gets this Expo right here, I believe, but not quite. So good stuff. The Queen's going to step up, get some value as well, and that's it. That's all he needs. Gets about half of the anti-air part of the base up there, about half of that taken out, the queen. There's nothing in the CC that's an issue. And comes at these four air defenses with his lava hounds and balloons. Now, he only has, I believe, three lava hounds. Or maybe he had four, I forget. But not that many compared to four air defenses he has to deal with. The difference is these air defenses are not well protected. They are not going to be doing as much damage because the balloons can close in quicker. And the balloons have nothing to worry about in the first half of the base because it's all air defenses. As long as the lava hounds don't pop, which they don't, the cannons and nothing in there can target the balloons. Now, when they do reach this area that is a problem, he has the heal spell. And the archer towers, the wizard towers, the Teslas can't do that much damage to balloons under heal. Plus, he has that lava hound left over that did some tanking, and there's a wad of balloons that's going to be left up. So you can see it works out perfectly. Either way works at Town Hall 10. You can take out the area with the archer towers, the wizard towers, the queen, the expos, the Teslas, with your heroes, your kill squad or whatever, and La Lune that side, like in this attack, or like in the last attack, go for the air defenses and use La Lune on the side that does not have the air defenses but has those archer towers and wizard towers. Either way can work. It depends on the situation. Hopefully these attacks are good models for you to have kind of a framework of what to work with when you're planning your attack. Okay, so finally, I have to mention the witches becoming strong. They got a buff in the update. They already were somewhat popular. I already saw them a little bit, Town Hall 11, Town Hall 10, but now we've seen them become more common. Town Hall 9, Town Hall 10, Town Hall 11, we're seeing them, and they are probably the witch bowler combination, probably the next biggest attack next to La Lune. It's probably second if you take air attacks, like specifically La Lune. Aside from that, it's going to be the next most common attack. You can see here on this one, comes in, just storms the middle of this base. Both Infernos are accessible from the core, takes advantage of that, and you can see how quickly this base falls. You want to have a group of witches and bowlers going to each side, so going around the side of each base. The witches actually don't even have to go into the core if you don't want. It can just be your heroes, the golems, and the bowlers, and you can use those witches and a group of bowlers on the outside. The witches now have enough HP to, you know, stand up to the wizard towers in the giant bombs even. They don't get killed by giant bombs. And the mortars, of course. So there's a lot more you can work with there at Town Hall 10. The witches and the bowlers are a good option. And as far as anything else we're seeing situationally certain kind of tailored attacks for bases, such as a queen walk bowler with back end loons, or a queen walk mass bowler with back end hogs. Certain attacks that are tailored to the bases. Unfortunately, I don't have an example. This video would probably get very long if I showed everything. The main thing is going to be your La Lune and your Witch Bowler. Those are the easiest ones to master, to get down, and hopefully they can get you some 3 stars in war. Now, if the base does call for a certain type of attack, you can tailor make your attack to that base, as you should for any strategy. Of course, there are variations specific to what base you're attacking. Okay, for Town Hall 9, just in the last few wars, we've seen hogs become more common. Specifically, and this isn't anything too new, these type of golem-based attacks where you can control the base. The difference between attacks that, you know, use 30-plus hogs or 30-plus balloons in a small kill squad versus kill squad-based attacks that use less hogs or balloons, you have more control when you bring the golems in the kill squad. It's more reliable. There's less of a chance something's going to screw you up. So I think that while, you know, there is variation in the number of hogs and the size of your kill squad, it's more reliable to bring the golem-based attack, especially if you have a good plan, you have high-level heroes, and the base calls for it. If your heroes are a little bit lower level, it's worth it more to consider bringing more defensive targeting troops, because the golems aren't as effective if the damage behind them isn't going to be as high. If you have heroes that are less than 20-20, that's considerably going to be less damage dealt. Even if you have the bowlers, than if you have 30-30 heroes like most of the attackers do in CWL. But of course, this video is supposed to, you know, be helping people beyond that top war caliber. So if you do have the lower level heroes, the golem-based attack's not going to be quite as effective for you, generally speaking, although, of course, it is powerful and it can work for pretty much everyone. So speaking of golem-based attacks, let's take a look at the air side of the equation. I wouldn't say this is more common than hog attacks. I'd say air is still more popular, but I just wanted to show the hog attack first because we've seen a small increase in the number of hog attacks. I think it's because the hog's got a very slight buff in HP, and I don't know, maybe, you know, the people are seeing value in bringing level 7 hogs. We've seen that a little bit in the CC. Instead of bringing bowlers, people bring more hogs and bring those level 7 hogs that are now even more powerful. So those are a little more common. This type of Laloon attack has been around for a long time. It's as effective as it ever was. You can see just basically coming at the base with the kill squad, it's hard to go wrong because you no longer have to take out the queen with your kill squad. You can use a skeleton spell on her. There's just so many options in terms of Laloon attacks. You can decide to go for, you know, a very small kill squad. We'll take a look at that in the next attack. You can do a Zap Quake. A little bit less common is the Zap Quake now. The 5 spell investment just isn't always quite worth it to invest for one air defense. The 5 spell space, that is. So we're seeing a little bit less of that, but it's popular now to see people not take out the queen with their kill squad, especially when you can get a ton of value by attacking the other side of the base. You can get air defenses and defensive targeting buildings for a cheap investment. If that's the case, go for it and just save a skelly spell and like a poison spell for that defensive queen, and she shouldn't be that much of an issue. So finally, for air, before we move on to one more other Town Hall 9 attack, but the last air attack we're going to take a look at is the mass air attack coming at the base strong from the sky. Just a small investment of the heroes. Immoral Thieves did a great job against Power COC in their first CWL war for Season 2 in taking out the bases with this strategy. Basically, you drop down your heroes and any support troops you need. It could be called Penta. People call it Penta if you have 5 Lava Hounds. Whatever you want to call it, these mass air attacks are very common and popular and successful. Now, this one I found so interesting, and I wanted to show it especially. Most attacks do deal with the CC troops in some way, but this one was a fresh hit, and he just didn't care. He came right at this base with a baby dragon in the CC, and basically just dropped, I think he had one poison or something. He had at least one poison and the lava pups, and that was enough to take out the baby dragon, and the witch in the CC wasn't much of an issue because she doesn't hurt air troops quite as much. So just kind of surprising how he just ignores the CC, doesn't know what's in it on a fresh attack, but just ignores it, comes at the base strong with 5 lava hounds, 20 balloons, and a bunch of spells, and just crushes it. So it just kind of testifies to the power of balloons and lava hounds still at Town Hall 9, and how sometimes you can just overpower the base. Now, there is a Tesla in the corner, so it's going to be a bit of a journey for his troops. We will go ahead and fast forward there. The lava hound does pop right there. The balloons make their way over and get it taken out. So nice attack to Raj. We're going to take a look at one more. Obviously, the hog attack, the hobo, and then the kill squad based Laloon and the mass Laloon are the most common for Town Hall 9, but we also are seeing, could witches be making an appearance on a grand scale at Town Hall 9? Possible. This attack was actually not that common in Immoral Thieves or OneHive Genesis that I was recording in over the weekend, but it was very common in the clan that Genesis went against. Terps went big. They used this attack a lot, and it was pretty successful for them. They wasn't, you know, hugely successful, but it did work on a number of attacks, and it might be something that starts to emerge. It doesn't quite take as much planning, and I don't want to say it's a spam attack because you still have to execute, but it's not quite as you plan each component. It's just put the troops in the right location and kind of see what happens. Drop your spells in the right places, and it can work out very nicely in some situations, as it does for Trinat 2016. What he does is not what everyone does. He goes ahead and invests, I think, 2 healers on each side to keep those witches and bowlers and wizards up around the outside of the base. Then he sends the queen, the king, and the golems and the bowlers up the gut of the base. It's kind of a mini version of what we see at Town Hall, what we used to see at Town Hall 11. We still do see it, actually. But what originated at Town Hall 11 and spread to Town Hall 10 and now even Town Hall 9. So the witches being seen at all Town Hall levels, at least all Town Hall levels 9, 10, and 11. Very interesting there. But yeah, that'll do it for this attack meta video. That is what's working right now, so do your best to try it out and get as proficient as you can in these strategies. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments, anything you think I left out. I'd love to hear. So that'll do it for this video. Like I said, I'm going to work on getting some defensive videos out to help you guys know how to defend these meta strategies. But that is probably going to be a little ways away, so stay tuned. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bisectatron out.